Using the model, the artist gets to work. He begins to sculpt a human face out of clay.
We had two copies of this, one as a reference and one to actually work on, with all the tissue depth markers in clay.
The markers indicate how deep to layer the clay as the artist brings the skull to life. Tissue and muscles, a face begins to take shape. Finally, we can look into her eyes. 4 centuries later, it's Jane.
I think that this reconstruction will give people a sense of what people did look like 400 years ago.
The reconstructed Jane also opens a window into the lives of the people who lived and died in the Jamestown of 1609. And now, Jane lives on as the focal point of a public exhibition at the Jamestown Museum. The reconstruction is the result of collaboration between scientists, patient work with endless attention to detail. And today, visitors can look at Jane and understand her story.
Archaeology has given Jane a voice that she did not have.
The surviving settlers of Jamestown discarded her remains. They didn't even have the strength to give her a proper burial. But that's what made it possible to tell her story today.
Jane is one of a kind, and the chances of finding the remains of a victim of cannibalism are so remote as to be unimaginable. This is an astounding discovery.